Welcome back to Just Scribble for an unboxing from Stylish and Minimal Co. So the name of their company used to be Sticky Monster Co. and now it's Stylish and Minimal Co. It's still the same like initials, SMCO. But they are one of my favorite tab shops to get tabs for my planners. I actually have three favorite types of tabs, potentially a fourth because I have some new tabs coming from a shop that I haven't gotten tabs from before. But SMCO, Stylish and Minimal Co. is one of my favorites. Gracie Edits is another one, and I actually have an order from her coming as well. And then Lexi Kylie Designs is my other one. The three of them, Stylish and Minimal Co., Gracie Edits, and Lexi Kylie Designs, they all have different types of tabs from each other. And I like all of them for different reasons, and I will be using all of them in my different planners. So different ones for different planners. But today we are checking out Sticky Monster Co. or Stylish and Minimal Co. They actually have both names kind of used in their branding. I don't think they've fully changed over because their sticker sheets still say Sticky Monster Co., but then like their Instagram and their website says Stylish and Minimal Co., but if you search Sticky Monster Co., it still comes up. So either way, Sticky Monster Co. or Stylish and Minimal Co., either way, you're going to get to the same place, and I will put links to website, Instagram, all of the things down below in the description box so you can check them out. But this is my order. It's mostly tabs, but I did throw in a few sticker sheets as well. It did come wrapped in this really beautiful rose gold tissue paper, and then they used a really nice sturdy envelope for it too, so they didn't get bent. Nothing got messed up in the mail, which is wonderful. So let's start with the little package. These are stickers. Some of these are freebies, and then some of these are things that I ordered. So I did get these Twinkle Stars. These are in their Icon Dot line, but I liked them a lot. And so I got them in two different sizes. So a smaller one and a larger one. And then I have this weekly stamp sticker sheet. So this is for Q1. So as your weekly stickers for all the weeks of Q1. So from January 1st all the way to March 31st. And so this is week one, this is week two, week three, week four, and so on. And then around the edge, it's kind of hard to see. This one says January, January, January. Then this one says January and February, February and March. So the month is like written around the edge. It's just really, really tiny. And then this is a freebie journaling sticker. And then I got highlighted days in the editorial font. I have an undated planner for 2024, so I'm just collecting all of the days. Then this is another freebie. It's in the same vein as the other freebie. It's just that this one is on transparent, and then this one is on like a white paper sticker. And then I bought these Matisse dots. I think that they're just really fun and different, so I thought they'd be good on a week that I was doing minimal spreads in my planner. So those are the stickers and the freebies. Well, the small stickers. There's stickers in here too, but they're bigger. So let's separate this out. Those are tabs. These are stickers. This is not a sticker. This is not a sticker. And these are stickers. All right, well, so we'll continue with stickers. So I got this trackers section divider. So it says trackers and then it has like a line. So you can lay it in your Hope in 2 weeks or your cousin or your Sterling ink, wherever it is that you're doing your tracking. You stick this at the top of where you're gonna put your tracker section, and it has a little line to create a divider, and then you put your trackers underneath. And then I got the same thing in a different font with a longer line. So you could choose your line length. I got one in a scripty font and one in a sans serif font, with two different lengths of lines. So I got the short line and then the long line. And I got these Hobonichi monthly stickers to use to decorate the monthly spreads in one of my planners. I don't have any Hobonichi, so it's not going in a Hobonichi, but they are sized for the Hobonichi cousin. So they will fit nicely on your Hobonichi cousin. They'd actually work nicely in your weeks or your A6 as well. And then I got these Hobonichi minimal stickers that have the number of the month and then the name of the month. I really liked the aesthetic of these, so I got those as well. And then I got this other set of monthly stickers, and this one has the number of the month like this and then the script down. So we have January, February, March, and so on. I thought it was really, really nice. I just liked it aesthetically. I really like her stickers and the aesthetic of her stickers. And then I have this minimal dashboard. So it's just like a piece of acetate that says inbox minimal. And then you can stick sticky notes on here or transparent sticky notes with your routine on it. You could clip a photo of your family to it, anything you wanted. And then it just goes in and kind of is a page marker in your planner. If this was your planner, this is an old Hobonichi Weeks of mine, you could stick it in and have it kind of pop out the top. If you can see that, so that you can find your page. You could put it in a bigger size planner as well, so it will fit in Hobonichi Weeks and larger. So it would fit in Weeks, B6 Slim, B6 Standard, A5 Slim, A5, all of the things. Everything bigger than a Weeks. And then I got this yearly overview. It's like, oh, it feels so good. It's like this thick, almost like vellum, but it's not vellum. It's so soft and it's so nice. And you could use it as a pencil board or as a page marker, whatever you want. And it just has the months of 2024 on it. I just thought it would be really fun to have to stick into my planner to use like as a page marker. And I wanted to kind of feel it. She has routine cards where you can get your routine like customized printed and they come on this. And I wanted to kind of feel this and check it out. And now I know I have to have one while I figured out what I would want to get printed on a custom one. So I have that. And then these are the tabs, which are basically the same material as this, like this beautiful, soft, thick. It's not vellum, but you would think it was vellum, except for that it's so thick and sturdy, and it's just so soft and so amazing. That is how her tabs are. So I did get 4 different sets of her tabs in assorted styles and or sizes. So I got her tiny tabs for the Hobonichi Weeks, and I picked this sans serif font. So she has all of the months of the year, and then she also adds one for trackers, list, inbox, and reference. So I got that set. These tabs are so durable. They work so well. They do come in, I think, like 12 shades. I'm not exactly sure how many, but you can get them in a ton of different colors. In the past, I've actually gotten them in a color, but this year I bought all of them in clear. But they are really easy to apply to your planner. They're pre-scored, so they fold over nicely, work really well on Tomoe River paper, even though they're a little thicker and more durable. I mean, they're not thick, but they're thicker than the ones that are just printed on a piece of sticker paper. So they're more durable than those. They hold up. They don't mess up your Tomoe River paper planners, which is awesome. And I just really like them. And I like the aesthetic. She has a couple of different fonts and then lots of different size options. So this one is made for the Weeks. She has one for the A6. She has them for the Cousin. You can mix and match. It really doesn't matter what planner you put them in. It's just what size and style that you want. She even has some that have circles at the top. So the month is printed in a circle. She has some that are just icons, so there's no words. Lots of options. And like I said, tons of different colors to choose from that are all kind of muted and neutral, but you could find one that fits your planner color style or your planner cover, things like that. So this is the Tiny Tabs Hobonichi Week size in the modern font. And then this is the A6 mini petite size. Once again, you have all of your months. Then it has a little paper clip, a smiley face, a little calendar, like a little chart for trackers, a check mark, and then a little envelope that you could use like to mark inbox or something like that. Then this is the Cousin size in her script. So once again, it has all of your months, but then it has daily, lists, monthly, weekly, notes, and trackers so that you can tab all of the sections in your Hobonichi Cousin and all of the months in your Hobonichi Cousin. I'm not using a Cousin because I'm not using any Hobonichis, but this actually works really well in Wonderland 222. It works in the Sterling Ink Common Planner. It works in the Journey Planner. It works in the Night Owl. You can pretty much use this in pretty much every planner on the market, and most of these tabs would work for you. And then the last one that I got is also Hobonichi Week size. This is the type, like a typewriter font. And so once again, it has the months, inbox, finance, weekly, monthly, lists, and trackers. So those are the 4 sets of tabs I got. That is the reason that I ordered, was for the tabs. But when you're paying shipping, sometimes you want to add other things, especially during planner setup time. And I needed some stickers for planner setups. And then I have an undated planner, so I needed some stickers for that. And then I just thought these were fun to add and check out and try. So that is my little haul from Sticky Monster Co. or Stylish and Minimal, whichever one you want to call it, because I've always known her as Sticky Monsters Co. That's what's in my head, but I do know her website actually says Stylish and Minimal at the top. If you have any comments or questions about my little haul from SMCO, please don't hesitate to put them down below and I will definitely get back with you. Give me a thumbs up if you liked this unboxing of my tabs and more from SMCO. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss future videos, and don't forget to just scribble.